Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Duo here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to Arcane Season 1 Episode 8, titled Oil and Water. Disowned AML and her visiting mother trade combat tactics. Caitlin and Vi forge an unlikely alliance. Jinx undergoes a startling change. Now, Mal and her mother, that was what that letter in the last episode was probably for. I forget which one of the reaction said that that was her, like, house, sigil, like how Jace's is the hammer. I don't remember seeing her house sigil, so I can't confirm that or not, but it makes sense if that would be their wax seal on their letters, if it is their house symbol. Caitlin and Vi with an unlikely alliance. Who could that be? Because I can't really think of anyone that they're either not already allied with or that they would ally with. Yeah. No clue about that. And Jinx undergoes a startling change. I'm assuming she's going to go even further off the deep end after everything that happened with Caitlin in the last episode, everything that happened with Echo. No, I have not seen the animated Arcane music video. I have heard about what is shown in that, but I still have not seen it. So, I am surface level aware of the Echo and Jinx stuff. But let's get this started in 3, 2, 1, go. Smell. You know, after everything that she was suggesting in the last episode, she sort of went down on my character tier list, but I can also see why she's doing it. More cunning than aggressive, I guess. You know, that sort of sounds like what she was doing with Jace. You've got to kill her to prove it. That was the wrong choice. We are not merciful. That is an interesting energy sword. Halo. That's what it reminds me of. Just trying to think of what. I don't remember if it's actually. It's been ages since I played Halo, so. Shit. I was gonna say, there's no way he actually could see her. Where the hell did Echo go? One, where the hell is Echo? Either his body would be there with Jinx, or it would have been blown to into the median, so he should have been visible if he was taken out by the bomb. Another thing that was posed by the reactors I watched that I've just remembered from seeing that. Those may have been Jinx's bombs. It makes sense. What with her being there, then flying behind Vi and all that, and exploding to get the crystal back so she could saunter in and take it. Makes sense. But also they were firelights, so. And we've seen the firelights use explosives or technology-based weapons, I guess. This is the first time he's seen death, isn't it? Oh, yeah, no, they were definitely Jinx. There's a reason they were painted to look like that. Yeah. I'm sure that's going to go down well. Right, I do remember Omni calling that guy Singe at the start, which I'm pretty sure he's a character from the game. He did say he wasn't sure, but the credits spoiled it. Did. Why did you use that in your fight against Vi? I thought that was drugs that he was heating up. No, he's just making his drink hot. You are a very tall lady. I can bring you home. Oh, she's from Noxus. That's what I said. Who the fuck are you? Radio then. Weren't there. That's, I don't know. I thought you was going to say that. Technically, you didn't. You stormed off in anger, and then Marcus took you before you could run back. You didn't run away. Right, yo. I do like how he had to drug Silco so that he could stop him from interfering in his helping of Jinx. What did she turn into? Amadeo, what are you doing? Who are you there to... Are you there to talk to the brothel leader as well? Spinning top. What's with the faces? That sounds more like a threat than advice. That's a name that she has an even more unique insight into this. He's gonna toss. Well, you've got a glowing foot, mate. Seems to have been slightly fused with his brace as well. happened to it? Are you inviting him to a research date? Don't inject yourself again. She's going to be hit by something, isn't she? And that is why you needed the shimmer. And look what you've done. Oh God, that's it's learned, all right. It's learned death. Jace, what are you doing? Is he making his hammer? A ruined chisel? So that's how she gets her gauntlet. It was the Atlas that she gets. She also didn't want him to say the things that he did. You know, that looks a lot more unwieldy than it does in the game. Because I don't, if I'm remembering correctly, the game one doesn't come all the way down to her elbow. It did say Caitlyn and Vi. Not just Vi. Oh, God. They've got fucking shimmer Spartans. Actually, upon closer look, it doesn't look like a halo helmet. It looks more like a diving helmet. So, Jace, how well do you reckon you can help use that hammer? Because combat's a lot different than forging. Once again, the visuals of this show are incredible. I don't remember it being able to do that. He's trying to run. Probably thinks they're there to finish him off. I was gonna say, what the hell, where does the blood come from? Oh, I think I've seen this. If I'm not mistaken, Jinx is there. Or maybe that was just a what if scenario from the drawing. I can't remember. I don't think it's said, but right. Okay, so Jace has killed a kid in front of a bunch of other kids. Were just the what's it called? The shimmered soldiers. That would have been fine for his conscience, I guess. Like, sure, he's still killing them, but they would have died anyway. However, the kids, they were just doing a job. They probably had no say in. Heck, half of them were probably forced to be there. Probably had no idea what their job was doing or what it was causing or anything. And one of the kids got hit, which is why you never engage in battle in an area where there are innocents, especially not with a hammer that shoots electrified magic blasts. Like, I don't remember his hammer shooting in the game. He is one of the, like, three, four characters that I sampled when I actually played it. It was him, Jax, I think it was Vi, and I don't remember who the fourth one is, but yeah. I don't remember having a projectile. To be honest, I don't exactly remember having the light sphere that he utilized, but I had a feeling as soon as he showcased those gauntlets off to Heimerdinger that was going to be Vi's eventual gauntlets. It is interesting that Mel's mother said something that I said in the last episode, that being, weapons aren't made to not be used. Sooner or later, they will be used. And, well, we see. Even though these weren't initially designed as weapons, they're being used in combat scenarios. So even stuff that weren't made, even things that aren't weapons, eventually get utilized as weapons. Pretty much everything has been. It was surprising to see all the counselors go for a more diplomatic approach. Then again, it was hammered in that was the difference between Piltover and Noxus. I don't know why, but as I said at the start of my reactions to the show, I thought Noxus was like an invading force set on conquering the areas. I also thought it was a different dimension bleeding into this one and trying to conquer it, but that's not the case. It's just on the other side of the world, I guess. Didn't know Mel was from there. Her brother died, so her mum tried to reach out. You'd think that... Then again, it is an opposing kingdom, so it would make sense that she wouldn't want there to be Hextech weapons. But you'd think a leader, like what we saw from her in this episode, would be all for advancements in weaponry to suit her, like, advances and all that, so... This was a very mixed episode. I don't want to say a mixed bad, because that makes it sound like there was bad things in the episode. There wasn't. It's just a cacophony of different emotions all within one episode. Because, like, you have the thoughtfulness, you have the questioning, you have the excitement of the fight, you have the kid being hit, you have what happened with Sky and Victor, you have everything just in one episode, all mixed together and really make you think. But anyway, this is the first episode that I actually need to process, so I'm gonna end this one here. I'll catch you in the next one.